In this tutorial, I'd like to show you how you can model an object in Maya that matches the real-world scale of the object that you're modeling. So what you're seeing here is a 3D model that I created inside of Maya, and that model is matching the scale of the reference image, and what you can see here is a ruler with some centimeters marked out on the side. This model in Maya is the exact same size and scale of the reference photograph that I've used to create the model. So that the size of the object in the real world when measured in centimeters is exactly the same size of the virtual object inside of Maya, also in centimeters. There are a couple of reasons why you would want to create your models in Maya that are based on a real world scale. And the first reason I can imagine is that if you're working on a team or you're part of a group project where each individual of the group is going to be making their own models, when you bring those models together to create the set and all the props in the set, you want all the objects in the scene to match the same scale. So that if you tell everybody in the group from the beginning of the project that we're going to model these objects to match a real world scale, then everybody has the same point of reference and all the geometry scale will match when you bring them all together into the scene. The second reason you would want to model your objects to a real-world scale is related to lighting and lighting effects. For example, when you set the decay rate on a physical light in Mental Ray, for example, the amount of decay in Maya is calculated based on the inverse square law and is set to the real-world scale. So the amount of distance that the light travels and the rate that the light falls off at, the decay rate, is all based on real-world measurements. So if you want your light to behave realistically in a Maya scene, it is important to start off by modeling your objects and having those models match the real-world scale. So those are a couple of reasons why you might want to model your objects at a real-world scale. I've divided this tutorial into three parts. The first part is the introduction that you're watching now. In part two, I'll show you how we can use Photoshop to take two photographs of our real-world object and combine them into one image that is symmetrically aligned. And then in part three, I'll show you how we can use that symmetrically aligned photograph and bring it into Maya and use it as an image plane so that we can model our 3D object to scale. You can find the links to parts two and three of this tutorial in the description below.